turn up. I'm breaking in, I'm at the pearly gates, but they won't let me in. I told the devil, I said, I ain't trying to sin, yeah. I ain't trying to sin.
Vibes only.
Of a lifetime of dreams. Which team will lift the Lombardi Trophy? We're about to find out. It's the Chiefs going up against the Cardinals. So the time has come. Let's send you out to the stadium and join the two men that will have the Super Bowl call. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, thanks, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and NRG Stadium in Houston. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Arizona Cardinals. First time with Johnson. And they're able to get this one across the 35. When we sat with the coaching staff a couple of days ago, they said attacking that defensive look with a run, something they wanted to do, it was effective.
And they were extremely confident, weren't they? Their planning, their preparation, they knew what they were going to get in that defense, and they were able to attack it accordingly.
All right, here we go.
Boom, landing! Over, over, over! Over, over!
Detroit! Here we go.
Detroit! Landing!
Here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. The all-pro Justin Houston in on the tackle. And certainly one of the mainstays in this offense is the crafty veteran, L. Fitz.
Love the way you phrased it. Crafty. This guy knows how to get open and catch the
watch
football.
Watch tight. Watch tight. Tight end right. Tight end right.
Back 99. Tally. Here we go.
Green 39.
Green. Here we go.
Blue.
All right, now. Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Watch you now, Barney. Barney.
Second down, Johnson.
Go, go, go,
oh, he's got a little daylight. 23 yards on the play.
Well, plenty of credit has to go to the guy carrying the ball. He broke the tackle and gained the yardage. But that doesn't necessarily mean that the defender is bad. They're not going to make 100% of the tackles all the time. Even the best in the game will miss one occasionally. The key is not to let it snowball and miss tackle after tackle.
Watch tight
on that play,
watch
credit
tight
to
tight
the
right.
offense,
tight
but that doesn't right. make the defense bad.
Got you now, Barney.
Check.
Barney.
Check.
Leopard.
Ship.
Leopard.
Ship.
Now let's go. Green 39.
First down carry here for Johnson. And able to push his way
That's
forward here for a good little
That's
game.
Good
yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six. And that linebacker group today could be very key.
As we were preparing for this game, you pointed out to me as we were watching film that the linebackers look like an elite unit. I agree with you totally. They move around, fly to the football, and take it away from offenses.
6 yards to go here on second down.
We got three.
Here we go
now.
Green 39. Green 39.
Watch it now, Barney. Barney.
Turn up.
All right, here we go. 19.
They pitch it out to Johnson, looking to find a lane, but he can't reined in at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be third down. Nice job there defensively to clamp down, because really, they've been on their heels this drive.
Agreed, and they really needed that one for confidence, just to feel a little bit better. But I don't know if I would be daunted by them stopping me on one run. This drive has gone pretty well. I could come right back
Watch
at them.
Tight. Tight ends right. Watch tight. Tight ends right.
All right, here we go.
Green.
No, 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 no. Check. Patriot. Patriot. No, 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 no. Check. Patriot. Patriot. All right, now. Lucky 56. Lucky 56.
Out of the gun now on third down. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Larry Fitzgerald was the intended target, and it's fourth down.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win, and the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the Cardinals have the first points. It's 3-0. A little bit of a lower trajectory there on the deep kick, and it worked.
Had to do it because he had to drive it out low because of the length of the kick. Able to do that, got it above the defense and over the post.
And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Three down.
Now a first carry for Latavius Murray. And he'll take this this one up close to the 25-yard line. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down. And this whole line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
To about the 35. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
How many times do we say in this game that speed kills, and it does it in so many different ways? In this case, you got a back who's quick,
under,
make people miss, but also gets to and through the hole before he throws it out. That's some of the benefits of that speed, not just outrunning people in the secondary. That led to a really nice game.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
To me, that's a superior play by the backer because he was allowed to, I think, run free on it and make that play. His defensive linemen, they covered things down for him because offensive guys, the linemen, what they're trying to do, as you
watch right.
Is block the guy at the point of attack and then climb to the next level and get the linebacker. And you're not allowed to climb. You got a free hitter, and that's what we saw there. And a really nice play resulted for them.
A good pick up there of 20 yards.
When the spotlight is at its brightest, and let's face it, it's the Super Bowl, those types of plays come out, don't they?
Absolutely. A big-time catch on the biggest of stages.
Do you think that one's going to live on? Right. We're going to see this for a long
time. Definitely
going to
live on forever with him. That's for sure.
No doubt.
Yardage here. It's a loss of two there, bringing up second down.
One thing that's really difficult for an offense is often identifying how to block a 3-4 defense. Well, when they're coming on a blitz, even more difficult. They're elusive targets and hard to hit.
Nice, nice, sweetheart.
On second down, here's Smith. It's Hill, complete. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down. And here is the Cardinal defense.
Calais Campbell is one of the tallest defensive ends in the league. Has the ability to get low and play the run and adds excellent kick blocking ability.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And he fires one that's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And a return comes to a halt right at the 44-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for three, except in certain situations, trying to ice a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get out of here.
No one did I've ever met.
Right side, Gresham. Now he'll be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
So much goes into a successful play, doesn't it? How about that play action there, freezing the defense just enough to bring the tight end free downfield for the completion.
Second down to the offense needing 5 yards. They'll come
hurry
out
up, here
in
we go.
The pistol.
Green 39! Green 39!
Ready to go now in the second quarter. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis. It's the Cardinals. Again, we'll see the pistol here.
Watch him now, Barney. Watch him now, Barney. Barney. Here we go now. Over. Over.
And over gives to Johnson. And he might have got this across midfield. Not by much. They'll mark it down at the 49. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Yeah, that wasn't a big run. Just a short one there. But guess what? Sometimes you treat it like boxing. You throw that jab out there, and you throw it again, and you throw it again. Then you come with a big punch later. Maybe they're just trying to set them up.
Tight end left.
Five receivers in the game. Four of them to the left side. He'll look to throw. He's going to go for a big play downfield. Ryan Grant, the intended target, and it brings up fourth down.
But they're certainly being aggressive here. It's like being a sprinter in a 100-meter dash, exploding out of the blocks, trying to push the ball downfield. Guaranteed, this defense better be on their toes. They're going to be tested all game.
This one will sail out of bounds. It'll depend on the spot here. But the side judge says that went out at the 7-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And the interception last time on the opponent's side of the field, certainly not what they wanted.
Put it mildly, that is so frustrating because that signifies there's a drive going on. You're in good spot. Great place to run some of your best offense. Instead, they turn
the ball over last time. See if they can avoid doing it here. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down.
When trying to create space for your running back, the first thought is how physical is the offensive line. Sometimes it's just positioning. On that play, it didn't matter about positioning or being physical. The defensive front, they out-leveraged them and won the battle.
The throw on second down is Smith. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Dayon Buchanan. And a first and goal coming up here inside the 10-yard line. Arizona getting ready to go as they take the field. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
They'll try and run. This is Johnson. Trying to find a lane, but instead he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. And no more. It's a gain of a yard, and it'll set up second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure on them.
Hurry up. Here we go. 3-19. Leopard.
Here. They're on the 8, and they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the 9.
There we go. Ooh. Hey, that's what I'm talking about, baby. That's what I'm talking about. High five, baby, high five. Let's go.
Now from back at the 9 after that last play, this is third and goal.
Single receiver.
In the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Dumping it off for Johnson. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Give him 7 on the play. And that will bring up an interesting decision here on fourth and goal. Boy, a call like this, certainly tougher to make in a Super Bowl, but they'll go for it on fourth down.
Here we go. Blue 90. Over. All right, here we go. Blue
90. Here we go with Johnson. And he will get into the end zone. Touchdown, Arizona. David Johnson, his 11th touchdown of the year. And the Cardinals will extend their lead. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. Now Catanzaro after the touchdown to kick it away. And out come the Chiefs now. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, ah, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still in their time. We'll see how they attack him here. They run with Murray, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
We just saw another example of how the defense is winning this game. Really at the point of attack, the offensive line is just getting pushed around. I think now as a play caller, you've got to give them a little bit of help. Maybe you keep your tight ends a little bit more. Maybe the running backs help you a little bit with the pass blocking. But you've got to help them get some confidence because you can't abandon the play calling right now.
Shift together here from the D line. They'll come out in the pistol. Here's Smith on second down. And he's got the hook up for the first time with a veteran, Jeremy Maclin. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You don't want that? You don't want that? You don't want that? Key to tight end. Key to tight end.
We got they come out here in the aisle.
Under 10.
Now again, this is Murray. He'll get this up past the 45 to the 47. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
That was a good strong run there. While it won't pick up a first down, it was definitely something needed by that offense. A positive run. They got a good push by their guys up front. Maybe something they can build on as this game continues.
They go with Murray again. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. 7 yards there, good enough to move the sticks.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that play on any down.
And the two-minute warning lurking. This will probably be the last play before we hit it.
Yeah, they want to get themselves in position to score this last shot before the clock hits.
Here's Murray. And a cutback left. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. 2 minutes remain here in the first half. We're back to Super Bowl 51 after this.
In the huddle right now or on the field, they're urging for a little bit more support from the guys up front. I actually remember one game where I hopped over a defensive lineman to make a tackle downfield and realized he was 10 yards downfield. That's not good. That's being driven off the line of scrimmage, and you can't have that if you're going to win a game on defense.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
But coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. I don't think you can get much more balance than this. Big time run, big time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about
double
that?
Tight.
Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Ready!
Now a toss running left. Here's Murray. Looking for a cutback lane, but nothing there as he's met at the line of scrimmage. Now here's a timeout defensively coming from the Cardinals. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Double tight, guys, double tight. Let's go, let's go!
Smith now to throw. Escapes the sack. He's got time. Call that a walk. And now the Cardinals going to use another timeout. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime.
right. Feels right.
Again, we'll see the pistol here.
Tech, move, 45.
From the pistol, they run it with Murray. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. Now hang on here. Timeout called. Timeout called by the defense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they get themselves on the board here. It's 10-3. And that field goal caps an 11-play drive.
That's a lot of offense to run to only get 3 points. But they'll take them. Anytime you can put anything on the board, you run to your sideline somewhat happy.
The Cardinal offense now making their way back out onto the field. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add lead, but a mistake there, that could change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take
Blue
the knee,
90.
Get on out for
Blue
the half.
90. Gone, gone! Check out, check out. Here we go now, here we go. 39!
And they'll start to drive on the ground with Johnson. And it'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a 2nd and 3.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around.
Here we go.
Excellent blocking.
Check,
but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
They'll look to throw here. He's got his tight end on the corner route. It's complete. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
Tight right.
And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. On first down, he'll drop to throw. It's complete to Jerron Brown. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain.
In today's football, where receivers break tackles, make people miss, get upfield for the extra yardage, when you see a play like that where it's caught and he's dropped on the spot, that's a big-time play by the defense.
Receivers in the game, four of them
Set.
To the left side.
Detroit!
Look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
On 3rd and 1, I think everyone in the stadium thought they'd try and run the football there, but they tried to surprise the defense and hit something through the air. Instead, it results in an incompletion.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. They'll spot it at 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So a good kick there, and they finish off the drive with 3.
And that should be the goal for an offense, finish each drive with points. So that's a nice job there to come away with at least something.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And now here comes Kansas City. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
It's a party now.
Set, ready!
They begin the drive with a run by Murray. And he'll take it ahead to the 28-yard line. So as the set designers rush out here to get us ready. And pump the brakes, Larry. Pump the brakes. We are ready for quarter number 3. Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Here comes the Chiefs offensive unit as they'll have it to begin quarter number three. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is. Right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there. This is a real doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them. Offense looking to avoid a third and long at second and 10. Another pistol look here.
Switch.
Off of play action. Here's Smith. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he's brought down after a good game. A good pickup there of 20 yards. So there on that play, offensively, they were in the crossing route. Defense was in zone coverage. So as a former DB, how tough is it to defend that?
It's really difficult because your natural inclination is to chase the receiver and maybe leave your zone. So you have to have discipline in order to talk to your other coverage guys and let them know that that receiver's crossing from your zone to the next zone. He's coming your way. Make sure you have him. And then when the ball is actually thrown, secure the tackle. When they're moving on crossing routes, if you miss a tackle, it usually results in a big play. Partner, he was going through his progressions. Not there. After about the third one, he decided he better pull it down and run for it. And he slides down and avoids the hit for good measure.
Move 45.
They keep it on the ground, but this time it's Murray. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four.
Well, he didn't make headway on that one. He's had plenty of carries all night long. I just wonder if maybe he's a little bit tired from toting the rock that much.
From the gun on third down, Smith. Flushed out right. He can run for it, and he will. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
On third and short, not only did he get away from the rush and pick up a first down, he picked up a whole lot more than that. And how did he get it done? Evaded the rush, kept his poise. Then how about him directing traffic as he moved downfield to pick up extra blockers? A really nice run.
Force!
Murray the lone set back.
Move 45! Over!
On first down, Smith. And for a third time tonight, he's intercepted. A great read, and it's picked off. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. The Cardinals offense now ready to get their first opportunity here in the second half. And last time, able to get three. It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Taken down at the 46-yard line. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's a good point you just brought up. So maybe if you still want to play zone, go to zone blitz scheme. And you can drop anyone out of your defensive front, defensive end, defensive tackle. It doesn't matter. You just exchange someone to bring more pressure towards the quarterback and still try and cover downfield.
And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down. Another pistol look here.
Green 39. Back to the left. Philly, here we go. Oh, let's go. Green 39.
Back to Johnson again. And able to break one. tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little gain. So they get half of what they needed. It'll be third and six upcoming.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
And the offense facing a third and six. Fitzgerald, and he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line.
Strength throwing the football downfield has never been an issue for this big guy. I still remember the first time I met him. He was playing for USC, and when I got introduced to him, I thought I was meeting their starting tight end, not their starting quarterback.
Such a presence, Carson Palmer.
Very much so. He's had it ever since he entered campus there and still has it today.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels.
Hurry up, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Palmer gives to Johnson. And able to get this down inside the 15, either the 13 or 14 before he's out of bounds.
And that's exactly what you want on a first down run. Pick up 5 yards, bring up second and five. The defensive line, though, they've got to figure out a way to out-leverage the guys up front because the offensive line is winning at the point of attack.
Set up to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And the stop will come inside the 5 at the 4. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage. If he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. You can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They got the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer. You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same
tight
case on that
Lucy.
Play.
Tight ends on the Lucy. Tight ends on the Lucy.
Now let's go. Green, 39. Green, 39. Hot.
Back now here on EA Sports. It's Cardinal football. They're also out in front of the scoreboard as we get set.
Detroit, Green, 39, Green, 39.
56, Mike,
56. Detroit, go, Detroit, 39.
Detroit's going to punch it in here from the one on second and goal. And I think they stopped him again. They did at the one-yard line. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down. From back at the two, here's third and goal. Stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a fourth and goal.
They went for broke on third down, and it would have really lit up the sideline if that one had worked. What do they do now on fourth down?
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This is less than an extra point, just a 19-yard attempt. And Catanzaro's kick is right through. And that will stretch the lead up to 13. So they settle for just the 3 there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. but three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
And now here comes Kansas City. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and then you turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 17 that time. And that'll be good for a KC first down. First down. He's got time in the pocket. He's got a man wide open. It's Macklin. And he's brought down. It's a pickup of 19. And it'll give the Chiefs a first down.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long. And then his receiver wanders into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Very difficult night for the guys on offense. They've got to be looking at each other in the huddle and on the sidelines. How are we going to find some open space to complete a pass and find open room to run? This defense all night long has squeezed down the passing lanes, made plays on the football. It's really been a thing of beauty for them. He's got to figure all day long prepping for the game. They had to talk about it again and again. Squeeze passing lanes, and we'll be in great shape.
So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down.
They threw the screen to the perimeter, but to no benefit at all. Tackle behind the line of scrimmage for a loss of yardage.
Wonder what's in the offensive playbook on third and 13. We're about to find out. And some changes here as the D-line separates some.
Force! Force! Check 31! Force! Force!
Third and long, it's Smith. Being chased out left. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39.
Partner, as a quarterback, sometimes you just got to know when the clock has gone off in your head, it's time to go. Tuck it and get all you can.
Second down.
In order for a screen pass to break big, a lot of things have to come together and be well executed, but all it takes is one small thing to go wrong and keep it from being a big game.
So second and 9, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here.
Over! Over!
It's Smith. That is caught inside the 5. And he's brought down after a good game.
Never make the mistake that the slot receivers, especially the little guys that we're watching here, are just quicker than fast. A lot of them combine quickness and speed, and they catch a lot of footballs, as we just saw there.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They'll try to run it in with Murray. And he is in. Touchdown, Kansas City. Latavius Murray taking it in. And the Chiefs are able to get this back within a touchdown. Solid job up front. Really just a solid job all the way around to get that one in.
That was well executed, wasn't it? Well blocked, well run. End result, 6 points.
Touchdown. Here's the Arizona offense now as they get set to take over. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. But we weren't happy about the 3 point kicker. Exactly. You put it through the post, that's going to help him in the contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that'll help him in the contract time. You could have kept that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
Super toe.
So they're leading. They have possession of the football. And certainly, this is where they just want to milk the clock.
Detroit! Blue 90! No. Check. Patriot! Go now! 319!
And the slot man goes in motion left.
Hey, check motion man. Put your hands on him. Get hands on motion man.
The busy night continues for Johnson. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. Here's a defensive timeout called by the Chiefs. It's just their first. They've got two more to use here in the final stages.
Crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do out going for them, they did score the last time. Looking to get the corner working. And what about the defense? Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, we gave up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. Down at the 48-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a third down. So on that play, defense was in the zone. They ran a crossing route offensively, but the defense there, you got to be good with communication, don't you?
You certainly do, and it's not something that is really evident when you watch it on the screen. But everyone's talking, communicating, pointing, and it keeps you from chasing receivers because you have a specific zone you have to cover. When a receiver's in your zone and he crosses to another one, you got to let your guy know. They got a completion there, but I like the discipline they show to stay in their proper areas and then make the tackle.
That's complete. A good pick up there of 20 yards. That's what they need right now. Get the first down, get out of bounds, stop the clock.
Just playing smart football, understanding the situation, making the plays necessary, and making sure that clock stops at every opportunity.
And now a first down following that long
end.
Game.
Watch that end. Tight end's right. Tight end's right.
Again with Murray. He's seen a ton of action tonight. And he's got this one down to the 10. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
Again, it's Murray. And this time he's not going anywhere. They'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. And 3 full yards here for the offense
tight,
to get on
left.
Third down.
Tight, watch left.
Tight, move.
Oh, Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It'll be their third and final timeout, so as they talk things over, we'll step aside.
We got double tight. Double tight.
Four down. Over. Over.
Check,
over.
Check, check, check. Good.
To throw. And this is caught. Touchdown. And now they're an extra point away from winning this thing in the final seconds.
And not only did they score, they tied the game. That means...
Yep, the PAT now can win it. Now the biggest extra point of this man's life. And it is good. And his guys have taken the lead in the fourth quarter of this Super Bowl. Here's the Chiefs kickoff unit now as they'll send this one away. The Cardinals offense now works their way back onto the field. Look at the clock. Everyone knows the situation. Probably time here for one final play.
And we know what that play is going to be. It's got to be some sort of Hail Mary, throwing it towards the end zone and hoping someone can catch it or catch it off of a tip. Think back to 2015. Didn't we see Green Bay pull that off twice
absolutely.
In the season? Once in the regular season, once in the playoffs. So stranger things have happened. It'd be interesting to see what the defensive strategy is about who they put on the field to try and knock that ball away.
Right,
and
right.
Tough starting field position here.
Alert!
All right, here we go.
Three
Green,
out,
39!
Well, look to throw. Johnson with a completion over the middle. And they're going to get this one all the way up to the 25-yard line. And the Kansas City Chiefs are the Super Bowl champions. For the victors getting to hoist that Lombardi trophy, you know, we've talked to guys that have done it, and they say there's no better feeling in sports.
I don't know how there can be. The journey to get to this game is incredible. And then to finally break through and win it when all eyes are on this game alone because there's nothing else going on, that's just got to be absolutely amazing. That, the task, incredible. But the accomplishment, forever.